Do you want to be able to take a character you've made, animate them incredibly quickly with hundreds of different animations from Mixamo? Well, I've made a script that's going to make this so, so easy. Now, before we get going, you'll find the script in a link in the description below. So remember to check that out. And if you've liked the video, give it a like and subscribe for more. See you soon. With your character open, you're going to have to export it in a format that Mixamo understands. So I'm going to export as an FBX and just click export. The default settings are absolutely fine. Over in Mixamo, upload your character. Click the upload button, select character file, and then go ahead and upload your model. This process will take a few moments, just be patient. Once it's done, the auto rigger program should show you your character facing forward. If it doesn't, use those buttons in the lower left hand corner to just change how your model looks. Once that's done, go ahead, click next, and then move these markers to the right place on your particular model, and this will set up the auto rigger for us. Now, you have a choice here to pick a skeleton level of detail. I'm going to pick the highest level detail. Be warned, this will cause a lot of animation data. About 100 animations will set you back about 500 megabytes of animation data. When you're happy with that, go ahead and click next. Now, that will take a few moments to do, but once it's done, you'll have a rigged character back and an animation will be playing. Just to confirm that. Looking good? Click next. The next thing you'll want to do is go ahead and download as many animations as you'd like. I would recommend downloading single animations in this particular instance so you can just use them as individual actions, but that's entirely up to you. If you download an animation that has multiple animations on one timeline, you'll just have to cut it up manually yourself later. A word to the wise here, you may want your animation to stay in place. For many of the animations on Mixamo, there's a button for that. At the bottom of your settings, you can click in place. Once you're happy with everything, go ahead and download whatever animations you like. Okay, once you've downloaded everything, what you need to do next is make sure that you've got a folder in the same directory that your model's in, and then drag the animations into that folder. I've named the folder in this case Anim, and remember that name because we're going to need it again in a few moments. Double check that there's nothing else but animations that you've downloaded in that folder. Because the actions within Blender are going to be named exactly the same as the file name, if you want to, go ahead and rename them appropriately for what you're going to use them for. Now that you've gone ahead and done that, comes the fun time. If you go ahead and toggle the system console, you will see the progress of the script as it's running, which is useful if you've got lots of animations. You can see it's actually still doing something. Go over to your scripting workspace or open up a text editor and load up the script. Once it's loaded up, there are two things you need to check. The animation directory name should match what you typed in earlier as your animation folder. Make sure it's named exactly the same, case and all. If you want to name your armature something else, this is the place to do it. I'm going to stick and leave it with armature. However, if you're planning to use your armature on several models, it'll probably be best to keep the name the same across all of them. Then it's just a matter of running the script. Either scroll along or click the play button or press Alt and P whilst your mouse is over the text editor. And you can see it runs incredibly quickly. A word to the wise here, if you've got hundreds of animations, this will take increasingly longer per animation. Okay, well, it seems to have done something. Let's go and check. Go over to an animation workspace or change one of your editor windows over to a non-linear animation editor. Excellent, we can see all of our actions there named exactly how we named them in the folder, and we can just select and hit tab and play back on any of these animations. And of course, now you can do whatever you like with them, and I hope you really enjoy this, and I hope this saves you a ton of time. It's taken me a couple of weeks to put together, but ultimately it's going to save not only me hours in the future, but it's going to save you hours as well. I hope you enjoy it, and I'll see you in the next video.